Welcome to I Learned a Thing in the Bathroom from Dollar Shave Club, where we explain something very complicated in mere minutes to occupy your brain while you shave. In this edition, we'll be discussing animal zombies, as explained by someone who sounds smart because he's British.
In most cases, when you're talking about animal zombies, what you're really talking about are animals whose brains have been taken over by parasites, forcing them to do stuff that's against their best interests, like, say, dying a slow, agonizing death. The South American fire ant, for example, gets preyed on by a parasitic fly that injects its eggs into the ant's body. When an egg hatches, the larvae squirms up into the ant's head and eats its brain. It then takes control of the ant's body, forces it to bury itself alive, then rips the ant's head off from the inside and escapes.
That is the most disturbing thing I have ever heard.
Oh, that was just the warm-up. Now we're going to get to the really bad stuff. Can you guess what one species of Costa Rican wasp does to the Aguirre orchard spider?
Is it something disgusting and awful?
Good guess. After the female wasp temporarily immobilizes the spider with her venom, she lays eggs on the spider's abdomen. When these hatch, the larvae stay attached to the spider, sucking its blood for nourishment. Once they're ready to move on, they inject another chemical into the spider that takes over its brain and compels it to build a web. A web completely unlike any it has ever made before, and one perfectly designed, conveniently enough, to house a wasp cocoon. The spider is then forced to sit quietly in the middle of the web while the larva kills it with poison and sucks out its insides.
I'm gonna go vomit now.
It's not pretty. When the wasp larva is done eating the spider, it kicks the corpse out of the web and builds itself a cocoon so it can finish growing. Then it hatches and the whole thing starts all over again.
So do all animal zombies end with the animal getting mind-controlled and eaten?
No, it gets much stranger than that. The loxo barnacle, for instance, makes mud crabs change sex. Once the loxo enters a male crab, it castrates it, then forces it to change its behavior so that it appears to be a female. When the change is complete, the barnacle lays eggs inside the crab. The crab looks after these eggs, then essentially gives birth to thousands and thousands of tiny barnacles before it eventually mercifully dies.
Animals are terrible.
It's not just animals. There are several types of fungus that do this stuff too, and in some really unpleasant ways. One fungus takes control of carpenter ant brains. It forces the ant to bite into the underside of a leaf and hang there by a very literal death grip. The fungus then grows inside the ant's body, sprouting a long stalk that splits through the top of the ant's head and shoots out spores, which then go on to infect more ants with a zombie fungus. And the circle of life continues.
Today I learned that the world is a horrifying nightmare.
Nature's great, isn't it?
Tune in next time for more I Learned a Thing in the Bathroom. And in the meantime, head to dollarshaveclub.com for more podcasts and a big old pile of grooming products.